Hi everyone, so this is the first bit for the integration pack 2. Part 1! It's always a part 2 pack as well. Right, so part 1 split into 6 lessons, and I would say they're straightforward, but you just have to practice. Everything's straightforward if you practice, I guess. Right, so this works from the idea of integrating the product rule. And I have this formula, which is in the formula booklet. It's important to know from this formula here that there is the question. That bit there is the question. Now what I do, this bit, I differentiate it, because that's where the du dx comes from. And this bit, I integrate it, so that's where the v bit comes from. I have to be careful how I choose what I integrate and differentiate. Unless it's a log, I differentiate something which reduces down in power to make it easy or easier in this second integral. So that's how it kind of says that here. Differentiate things like x or x squared. It's not necessarily the first term. It's just a bit that is easier to deal with when you differentiate it. Right then. So I'm going to set u as x and dv dx as sine x. So I'm integrating, but I have to differentiate within my integrative. So u becomes du dx is 1, and then v becomes minus cos x there. If I just look at the right hand side of the formula, it's uv minus the integral of v, du dx dx. And I literally just put the bits in the right place. So u is x, and v is minus cos x. So that's going to be, I'm going to tidy up, a minus x cos x. Then it's minus the integral of v, which is a minus cos x, multiplied by du dx, which is 1. So can you see that it's easier? Because I differentiated the x to make it into a 1. So if I tidy that up, there. So now I need to integrate the second part of it. So it's minus x cos x. Cos integrates to sine. And then plus c. There we go. So I do uv minus the integral of v du dx. So it's one for you to have a go at. Set u as x. Set dv dx as cos x, and have a go. There you go, hopefully you got that. Let's keep going then. Nice, is I like integration like that. So this one's got limits in it. So once again, I choose the x because it's the easiest one to do. It reduces down. So u is equal to x. So it isn't because it's first, it's just easier to do. So differentiate the u, integrate the v. So remember with the e, if you were differentiating, the 3 goes at the front, but I'm integrating, so it's a third instead. And then the formula is uv, which is that bit. So that's going to be x times by a third e to the third x minus the integral of v du dx. Dx. So v is a third e to the 3x multiplied by 1. I always put my bits in and then simplify it. Always simplify it before you try and do anything with it. Some stuff might cancel out. Some stuff just might look a little bit easier once you've simplified it. So I always like literally take a step back and stop to do it. Just realise I've not checked if they're yet, so I've checked if they're working. the microphone. Right, so if I integrate e to the 3x, it's a third e to the 3x. We've done that. But it was already a third of it, so now it's a ninth of it. There, and that's my answer. I like this, it's really good. Oh, I know. Oh, but anyway, I've got limits. Let me get rid of that for a second. So it's got limits between 0 and 3. It's based on that, it's too much now. So if I put the 2 in, now remember last year when you integrated with limits, if you put 0 in, you got 0 out, but you might not necessarily get 0 out this time. I will do on this first term, because it's a third times 0, but on this other one here, I won't necessarily. Right, so what have I got then? So I've got 2 thirds, I have to cram this in now, because I've got that limits. 2 thirds e to the 6, minus 1 ninth e to the 6, and then I've got a times 0, so that disappears. I've got an e to the power 0, which is 1, so that's going to be minus a minus a ninth, so plus a ninth. If I add the 2 thirds minus a ninth, so 2 thirds is 6 over 9, take away 1 over 9, and I'm left with 5 over 9. So I've got 5 over 9, e to the 6, plus a 9. Sorry, I forgot that for myself. I'll carry it away and spread myself out. So you don't spread yourself out, take it easy. So u is 2x, dv dx is e to the x. Now I don't put the limits in until here, until I've finished the integration bit. So I don't bother with the limits until I've done it. I think it just overcomplicates it having the limits in. So it was a uv minus v dv that was my limits in. Nice little bracket there. So there's an integration about when to do next. I'm going to stop the video and do another video. Join me.